Let's bring up the people who are going to be playing the mouse.
Emily Rock.
Avery Barger.
Serge Gonzalez.
Okay, so can I have the location that you had your last serious conversation? Like where you went, you know what? This is going to be tough. Let's go to the...
It's the radiologist.
Where did you say?
I said the radiologist's office. So, you don't have to go with that.
No, wait a second. I'm liking this. Hang on. This could go to a really dark place. Right? But we're okay with that. Okay, let's say you've just come from the radiologist's office and you go, I gotta go sit with my friend Jared and I gotta tell him what they just told me in the radiologist's office. Where do you go in order to do that?
It's your
diner. I'm saying diner.
Treehouse.
What?
Treehouse.
Yeah, it's the treehouse. Very, very important place. Okay? No, we're going with treehouse. But it's not just any treehouse, guys. This is not just any treehouse. This is an adult, not an adult treehouse.
It kind of is, guys.
It's a luxury treehouse. It's well appointed. It's got a beautiful view out among all these trees. It's got things going on. It's got an entrance that you climb up a ladder into there. And this is an exit that goes up higher in the trees to where all the chestnuts are. Okay. And now, what's a group of people that you go, I miss my group of people, my
monkeys.
I miss
bowling team.
My bowling team that met at camp. Right? So these are very close people. These people have known each other for a long time, and they are in the treehouse that they all bought together. Can we start with just one of you in the treehouse, just to kind of feel it out? The rest of you can have a seat, be out of the way. Don't trip on that, which I've tripped on 10 times.
You're fine. Stop talking yourself. You're fine. Here. You didn't tell us it was so high up.
God. Sarah!
Yeah.
We brought a lasagna. We brought a lasagna. You can just put it in the oven when it gets up. But do you have like a dumbwaiter or something? I don't want to carry it all the way up.
It's so heavy.
It's a really big lasagna.
The noodles are floppy.
I have a bucket on a rope.
That's creepy, but it'll do.
Just make sure it's clean.
Yes, it's clean. All right, here we go. Sending it down.
Ow!
Oh!
I said to watch it.
You didn't have to drop it that fast.
Okay, you know what? Clem, a little less criticism. We'll go a long way here, okay? Is the lasagna in the bucket?
Yeah, it's in the bucket.
Yeah.
All right, jeez, God. You cook this with bricks?
Yeah.
A little less criticism, I'll go with it.
Okay. Okay, I got it.
I don't know, I'm tired already, I'm halfway there.
We're hungry, yeah. Hey, Sarah.
Yeah?
Can we come up?
Do we have to knock?
What's the password?
The password is I've known you since 1971.
Don't age me, Clem. You know I don't like it when you age me. Yes, just come up.
You have to carry me the rest of the way. Don't trip on that thing!
I'm trying not to, Deborah. This thing's fucking high.
Vertigo. Wait, I'm gonna trip on that thing.
The sauce is great.
Thanks.
Sit down. Take a load off.
Yes, the sauce.
You know the sauce.
She gets it. I don't get out. That's fine.
Clam. Clam.
Sarah.
Clam. Clam.
You don't have an asthma inhaler, do you?
Yeah. I got one upstairs. I'll be right back.
Walking on eggshells here already. I don't want to be the first one to say it. You know?
It's pretty. It's just dizzying. Wow, I'd be dead if I really had a bad attack.
Who let you in?
Who told you the password?
We guessed.
Took a lucky guess.
You've known me since 1970? You guessed that?
Yeah.
That's fucking amazing. I'm sure the best chestnuts we have. I'm just gonna sit here next to... What's that supposed to be?
Huh? It's a lasagna. Pop it in the... Just pop it right there in with the lasagna. It's a big one.
Well, geez, this place is really good looking. Did you have a hard time getting the grand piano up here?
I built it inside myself.
You're incredibly talented.
Yes.
Take a couple of lessons from him on construction.
You given lessons on construction?
It's just a hobby. I'm not sure I'm going to ruin it. Do you mind if I try your lasagna?
Well, it should bake.
I'm just going to, you won't even notice what is missing. I'm starving. I'm picking chestnuts.
Well, take a piece.
That's why we brought it here.
Take a piece.
Oh, listen, the floor creaks a little. That's scary.
Just a slip. Lasagna.
Yes. It's Italian.
What region? It's a.
Napoleon.
Something like that. Napoleon.
That was my grandparents' recipe. I lost the accent when I grew up.
It passed it down. I got it.
It's interesting.
Yeah. Interesting. I got it. I got the inhaler. All right. I see you guys. You've met Javier. You remember Javier?
Ah, that's what it was.
Javier.
Sorry.
He's very forgettable. The height.
I know. I called him. Sorry.
So.
What was the other?
The lasagna's here, the chestnuts are here, Sarah, you have the inhaler, Deborah, so let's just get down to brass tacks.
Yeah.
We're here to talk about.
Oh, God.
So I'd love a drink.
Oh, Javier, would you mind?
Not at all. What do you like?
Anything wet.
Why?
Anything
to make me not so.
I fucked up when I called him Paul. I'm sorry. I know. I liked Paul.
Well, Paul's dead. And you just. How
Oh, talk about a Tamler. Well, we just met Javier. You know, you have to give us a little time to get used to him. We, you know, we spent so many years with
Paul.
Team. I used to sometimes borrow sponge bowling shoes.
We were the same. We were the same size shirt. So I know we had different last names, but I forgot my. He had an extra, and I wore
it. It brings back memories.
Javier's a lot taller.
He's so tall. I think it might actually be a disorder. That's why I called you here to talk to you today. I brought you to the treehouse.
Of course.
And we appreciate that.
I thought it was because it was the second anniversary of Paul's death. And I thought that was weird because Javier's going
to
be here.
Do it in all in one thing. Paul's death, you know, Javier's disorder, and the fact that you guys are getting divorced. I was just like, you know, rip off the band-aid.
Yeah. You told him?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I did.
There is no surprise, is
No, there's not.
I'm gonna
get me a divorce wine.
Yeah. Oh, Javier's back.
Listen, Javier, chestnut flavored margaritas.
Yum.
Here you go.
Get your own, Mr. Divorce Man.
Thank you. Truly fearsome.
Cheers to.
Cheers.
To new beginnings.
All the way around. Yay!
Yeah.
This
I like the
really
bit
good.
Of the bit of crushed shell with the salt around the rim. It's nice. It's
nice. Attention to detail. You know, we built that grand piano.
Yeah.
We heard.
Yeah.
I just think it's amazing. I mean, in the middle of the night, do the squirrels sometimes come and plants?
No, but yeah. The raccoons, surprisingly.
The squirrels are better, but the raccoons are more persistent.
Yeah.
You might want a videotape that makes the money off of them. That would be incredibly original. It would take the place of cats playing piano. You could have raccoons and charge money. And make money off of a thing like that.
I'm concerned about Deborah. I feel like she's not taking this day well, all the news, ripping the band-aid.
Yeah. I think we should just, now that we're all in the same room, let's just name it. I called you Paul. Today is Paul's second Yahrzeit. He was Jewish, even though the rest of us are Italian. Not that there can't be, you can't, but typically you think of it as different. And we're getting divorced. And she has. I'm sorry. Damn it!
I told him about that, the height disorder.
It's worse than that.
There's something else wrong with you that Deborah knows about that I don't?
They're changing the name of the disorder to my name. I don't know how this happened, but changing gigantism to Javierism. My face is right above it. Next year's the Yes, I'm fine.
it's mainly psychological.
Both wonderful and horrifying. It's just a margarita of emotion.
It's really good, Javier. And, maybe you can market this too, and you can be known for other things. Raccoons and chestnut martinis and that thing you have. The radiologist. It was on the night. That's where I heard it.
I mean, I can't hide it, but he didn't have to say I have, like, extra bones.
Well, you know, once this stuff hits the papers and the TV, you can't hide it anymore. It's out there. Lots of things are out there. Now.
Thank you for the cryptic allusion. What? Well, you're fine.
I need an inhaler. I used an inhaler. I'm not always fine. Always belittling my illnesses.
Not always belittling your illnesses.
If you wanted to know why we're getting a divorce, it started with this.
With your illnesses?
Yes. I think you're a lot more sympathetic to Javier's illnesses than my has been to mine.
What do you have against clenbuterol?
First of all, I invented it, so I know what it's for.
He actually is clenbuterol.
You're clem?
Yeah, I'm clem.
He's that clem. No. I told you I know people. I know.
I was gonna say, I'm a pulmonologist, so I don't know how much help I can be with your, you know, but
Javier,
I know my way around lungs, I know my way around asthma, I know my way around... You know, generic albuterol.
I mean that. He makes me think generics. You can't afford the brand name Mr. Pharmaceutical Genius Multimillionaire. He makes me think generics.
Why would you? I have an idea. I'm sick. There's a pill that I can take that's gonna help. It costs $8, but there's a generic for $2. I'm gonna take the expensive one. Just to show that I can. Because I have money.
Well, you could drive a Chrysler, but you drive a Mercedes. Just to show that you have money.
A Chrysler is not a generic Mercedes.
I could have a real diamond ring, but I have a cheap imitation. Yeah, that's another reason we're getting divorced. He's cheap.
Oh, Clem.
I'm going
upstairs.
Did he say upstairs?
I'm going upstairs! There's something higher than where we are.
Chestnut storage.
And it?
All I have, you don't mind, but I love your decorating, but I don't want to see the upstairs. This is high enough.
This is fine. Deborah, I know it's been a lot. It's been a day.
It's been a day.
It's been a half. So sit down. We'll finish the margaritas. Just take a breath. You know,
easy for you to take a breath.
You know what? I'm gonna get you another meal.
You could give me
name brand.
Thank you.
Because
he's cheap. That's how it starts. Penny pinching and being cheap. And not appreciating the finer things in life. Don't let that happen to you.
He doesn't matter. You can do much better than him. You really could. I mean, I thought it was a good deal since you have your condition and all to be married to the guy that invented it, but
you're absolutely right.
You could do way better.
Thank you.
Yes.
Don't let anybody ever tell you that you are not more fantastic than Paul. He was okay.